Hello, hi everybody. Welcome to week 11. So we talk about the NoSQL relational and non-relational database. So this is the content of the slide. So we'll talk about the introduction of the NoSQL, and then we also talk about the other company, which is a Facebook. Is how what database does Facebook use? And we also do like a comparison between the NoSQL and relational database and the database itself, and what's the key value store, column family database, document database, graph database, object database, the aggregation and transaction, how to use the map reduce, the contents, the consistency and the distribution. So basically, NoSQL database provide a mechanism for storage and retrieval of data that is modeled in mean other than the tabular relations used in relational database. So its acronym stands for not only SQL. So this suggests SQL is not going away. It has its application. The technology of NoSQL has existed since around 2009. Google and Amazon faced problems with very large data set and the performance limitation of relational database. Relational database do not work very well in cluster environments such as cloud. They were often based on a per server basis. For example, you will be charged more if you use several instances of an Oracle database on different servers for faster processing. Although not all companies have to deal with as information as Google or Amazon, companies have become interested in collecting data about the way users use social media or even games. To do this, they like to store content they find on the web. Most contemporary web documents do not have a predefined structure. Think of a Facebook page. No one can predict the structure of a news feed. No SQL database do not require a strict schema for the database, for the data, and they were designed to deal with very large data set and to use as many servers as available, making them ideal for cloud and other clustered environment. So basically, Facebook serves at least 570 billion page views per month. More than 3 billion photos are uploaded every month. The system serves 1.2 million photos per second. To cope with the volume, the company such Facebook use the technology of NoSQL, basically a relational and several non-relational databases. The MySQL database keep the data for user and page feeds. Accessing data from MySQL is slow. Therefore, Memcache is used and an intermediate in-memory storage. This means the FB page can be pulled in memory from a multitude of fragments. Hashtag is an object database that store all the picture. Cassandra is used to store the inboxes. Scribe is a scalable login system developed by FB. Hadoop is another column database which is used for data analysis. Other product involved in Hive, a data warehouse facility which work with the to Hadoop to enable SQL querying. Such a diverse data storage model is known as polyglot persistence. Relational database are designed to be integration database, central data store for application that work on related entities. When a customer is adapted, the customer new data is instantly available to all applications that use the same data store. Because a central database like to keep a single copy of each entry in a consistent state. But if all applications compete for this one customer entry, some of them may have to wait, and the database takes a long time to respond. In rational world, distributed models are often set up to remedy this. Replication is used to maintain several copies of the same data. All copies can be made available to the outside world. Setting up replication can be very difficult if the expectation is that the data remains consistent. In the world of NoSQL, databases are assumed to be application specific. Each application maintains its own data, and we accept that there may be overlap between the data store. The same customer may exist in several databases, and the entry may not be consistent with each other. Non-relational database can easily be developed to a cluster of computer because they were specifically designed for such environment. A great number of different data structures have been developed by different NoSQL products. Graph and multi-dimensional database focus on the relationships between entities, which can be numerous and complex. The most popular NoSQL database are aggregate-based. An aggregate is an entity that consists of several entities that would probably be stored in different tables in a relational database. The difference between columns family store, key value, and document store are not very clear cut. Key value store can only retrieve entities by key. If you add an ID field to a document in the document store, it becomes similar to key value store, in that we can also retrieve this document by its key. Column database also have key for the entities they store. You can picture the IDs field in column database like primary key in a relational table. Column store also have attribute name, which are very similar to attribute or column name in relational databases. One feature that all of them have in common is that they not enforce a rigid schema. If we sell pens and loan mowers, we can specify the viscosity and color of the pen, its waterproofing abilities, and time required to dry. And we can also note that the lawnmower comes with a year-to-year guarantee and an electric engine. Such details are hard to accommodate in relational databases, because with such products, most attributes will be different, and it will be very difficult to accommodate them in a common product table. In NoSQL, we can create a collection of aggregation and add both the lawnmower and the pen. Each aggregate can have its own attribute. Key value store use hashing to store an entity as blob defined by its key. Hashing use a mathematical function to transform the key into number that is used as memory address. Because this number points straight to the value to retrieve, hash may are very quick to search, but only if we search by primary key. Any other part of entity cannot be used as a search criterion. Some key value store, however, have more functionality and let you store object by type, and they can search by object content. Basic key value store put the data into buckets regardless of type. Unlike document and column family databases, they don't suggest you distinguish between type of object. They can all go in the same bucket. However, having different buckets help organize the data, and key value databases give you the option of having a number of buckets, each of with a certain type of content. So you can use a bucket like you would a table in the relational model. Most key value store don't let you query for a list of key. So if you forget the key to a value, you cannot get the entity back. In most products, you cannot search the entity by except by key, and relation between value cannot be constructed. Therefore, key value data store are often used in store temporary data such as shopping cart and session data. Precision support is generally limited, but varies from product to product. Basically, column value store group data into entity that look like raw data in a relational database. Unlike in the relational model, for each row, there can be different column. The column for all row from the column family. The example show a column family as in button A, Cassandra. The first name in the leftmost box are the row keys that define the entity. Each row has a number, the name value pairs. The name is the value name and the value is the actual data. When we have a simple column, only the name of the column and the data is mentioned. We can also have super column which have sub column, meaning we can have nested column. For super column, you have to mention the world name and value to tell the database which is which. For Cassandra, we use JSON notation to do this. Super column are a handy tool to group related data, but the data of the entire super column has to be fetched into memory when of the super column is needed. Therefore, column should only be grouped if they are most accessed together. Cassandra has sophisticated right model to update data that is designed for performance. It also has SQL like query language SQL. The common database store collection of similar data. The entities stored in a collection can have relation to the other entities, which make the design similar to a relational model. The entities can also be stored as larger aggregates. Aggregates are larger entities that include smaller entities, which in a relational model will be accommodated in separate tables. The entities are described in JSON or XML format, then stored in a collection. A collection is the document equivalent of a relation. As you know, JSON and XML has a tree structure. So documents that use this format have an implicit schema. So you also know by now that this format are semi-structured and do not necessarily define a very small piece of data in them. What more, inserting JSON document into collection doesn't mean it has to have actually exactly the same tree structure as another document in the same collection. The database does not enforce the schema. If you add another entity with different structure to the same collection, the database won't complain. The transaction generally cannot span more than one database operation. If you have to update data into collection, you need two operations. Therefore, there generally is no possibility of a transaction when more than one collection is involved. Graph databases are storing entities and their relationships. The relationships are directed and have a meaning. They were like joins in a relational database. Traversing a relational leads to another entity. In relational DBMS, joins are slow and to be avoided when performance is important. Graph databases are optimized for traversing relationships. In graph database, entity can have any number of relationships, and each entity can have different relationships. Relationships are important, and properties can be added to them to describe them in more details. The graph database are often used for applications that make suggestions of related product of website. Because every node can link to every another node, graph database make the use of cluster server harder. Although, for example, infinite graph supports distributing the nodes over a cluster of server. Neo4j supports structure fully. We say it is ACID compliant. Hashtag is simple object database, like a log file. It stores all entries one after the other. The entries are called needle and occupy one of two files, the actual store file. There is also an index file that points to each entry in the store file. The index contains pointer to actual data, information about the size of an entry, and whether it has been deleted. Relational database define relation by unique identifier, and there is a little choice in defining the entity if you want to apply a proper relational model. In NoSQL, we have great freedom in designing our collection. We can decide to include the customer, order, and product data all within one entity, so they are combined and stored in the same location for fast retrieval. There is no need to search for the customer, order, and product separately to perform a join. They are already combined in an aggregate object. This does not mean you cannot bring the customer entity on its own without including order and products. Part of an entity can be retrieved without problems, but you have to be aware that there are several copies of the same data. The same product have likely have been sold many times. When it is stored in combination with the order, there is a new product entry for each order, even if the order is about the same product. I don't think a single entity is transactional because the aggregation is the smallest entity we can work on. How much data be combined into one entity? This depends on how you use the data. If your application process mostly orders and you don't sell the same product often, it is meaningful to combine customer, order, and products. You have to be aware that some data is repeated in this design, but you do not have to store anything about an entity every time. Suppose the engine of lawnmower is not interesting to one customer. You may choose not to mention it on that customer order, and you so don't have to store the information either. The same product can be stored differently in different orders. If you decide to separate the entity's customer, order, and product into different collection, NoSQL database let you model relationship between this entity. But you have to be aware there is no transaction support for entities that are not stored in the same collection. There is no way for ensuring the order and product are adapted in the same transaction in the model shown here. When we have a database set up across a cluster of server, in this model, we are not guaranteed that the collection are stored on the same server. We have to make a judgment call whether have to collocate them. Note that is in the model, there is no duplication. We can reference the same pen product for several order as we do in the relational model. MapReduce is a way of subdividing a computation that use many resources so that the computation can be assigned to many processors that work in parallel. Because one of the advantages of NoSQL database is that they can easily be distributed over a cluster of server. MapReduce is an important part of NoSQL database performance. Database entries are typically hosted on many servers, and the server have to collaborate to retrieve the data. If the query asks for a listing of entry, a summation, or other calculation that involve several entities. Because many NoSQL databases are aggregated database, finding information from part of the aggregate is time-consuming. MapReduce help with this. It subdivides the jobs into subtasks and collects the answer. Suppose we have store orders, order entries, and customer as an aggregate in a single collection. Now we like to find out how many liters of a certain type of pen we have sold. So we have to go through all the aggregates in the collection and extract the ones that includes the particular pens. The map procedure split the task of extracting all pens entry from and the aggregates into subprocess that can be executed in parallel. Each map subprocess access one order aggregate and return the required data as a key value pair. When a mapping process has finished, its result is sent to reduce function. In the basic MapReduce implementation, only one reduce function collects all the results when there is only one key we are looking for. This may be fast enough, but if we are looking for the information for several products, the reduce function can be partitioned. In this way, one reduce function can look after one or few key that is collected, and all reduce function partition can work in parallel. In the NoSQL world, databases instance are often replicated over several units of hardware. Because NoSQL was designed for large dataset and high performance, distributing the database to multiple nodes is a common strategy. Replication means copy the same data to several servers. This helps distribute the query load. The queries are often redirected to the server that is geographically close. The problem this causes is write consistency. Every update of a collection has to be repeated for every copy. There are several strategies with this. Database can be configured to update all replicas before the update is considered complete. It can also be configured to update just one replica before the update is considered complete. A common strategy is to choose a majority of copy for update. This means that once 2 out of 3 possible replicas are updated, the process is considered complete and the third replica is update done whenever the database has time. Naturally, how many instances are updated immediately have an effect on durability. If a server fails and the update is lost, is the another copy has the update, the more copies are updated immediately, the lower the performance. Naturally, if you only have one copy of each collection, replica consistency is not a problem. Durability then only depends on how often you backup the data. Basically, sharding is a way of subdividing database so that the lot of the data processing tasks are distributed between server. The challenge for the database administrator is to subdivide the data so that the lot is even. Another challenge is to subdivide the data in such a way that only one shard needs to be accessed for any read or write operation. Aggregate help with this. They already bundle data that is frequently used in combination. Sharding can be done horizontally or vertically. In example, there is vertical sharding between shard 1 and shard 2 and horizontal sharding between shard 2 and shard 3. Sharding does not help with durability or resilience. If one shard fails, its data is unavailable. If masters left replication, the master receives all the updates. Application process updates the slave. The slave are read only. This is particularly useful when there are many reads of the database and relatively few updates. It is also resilient setup. Many databases can appoint a new master automatically when the master fails. This means we have a hot backup. The slab are backup nodes that are always current and in this case of failure. They can be appointed as new master. When there are many write operations, a peer-to-peer setup may be useful. Each node can receive more operations and the replication process copy the data to other peers. The only difficulty is consistency. If the same data is changed on two replicas, a conflict resolution mechanism is needed. So this is the summary of this slide. There are 7 things here. The first thing is a non-relational database has become popular for their performance and ability to accommodate large amount of data. Polyglot persistence use many NoSQL database to store different parts of the application data. Aggregate-based database embrace data duplication for quick access. The NoSQL database are easily set up in a distributed fashion. Sharding and replication are used to enhance performance or in the case of replication to ensure durability. Map reduce is often used to execute computation on large database dataset in parallel. Support for transaction is often limited and inconsistency have to be tolerated. So, this open question, I will pause this thing in the Canvas discussion. So, I hope you can answer this question in a Canvas, as currently our university management measure the student position in the Canvas. So this is the question. Please normalize this table to the third normal form. Show all step. If applicable, show the normalization form one normal to form to another. So that means you need to normalize this table to the to become third normal form. So in this case, you need to show the workflow how you did it from the first normal to become second normal and the to be and the last one to become the third normal. So I think that's all for this week. So I hope you enjoy the slides, and then don't forget to answer the open question. Also please don't forget to do the lab assessment. Okay, thank you.